asleep now, take what you need, you'll think you'll last. Whatever you wish to keep, you better grab fast. He understands you're open with his gun, crying like a fire in the sun. Look out, the saints are coming through, and it's all over now, baby blue. The highway is for gamblers, better use your sense. Take what you have gathered from coincidence. The empty-handed painter on your street is drawing crazy patterns on your sheets. The sky too is folding under you, and it's all over now, baby blue.
Well, howdy there, pluckers. I was Sawfingers again with you with a really old classic song from 1965, and Bob Dylan's classic song, It's All Over Now, Baby Blue. So this was made when he was in his very, very early days, when it was just him, his guitar and his harmonica, okay? No other backing band, just him, okay? So now then, what you heard there was basically two verses, but it just repeats about another two verses. It just, there's nothing else in the song but verses, okay? So, quite unusual tuning, okay? It starts, it's basically almost standard tuning apart from the bottom E string, okay? Very unusual. It's standard tuning with a capo on the second fret. This is for his, I mean, in later years he changed the key to E. I'm playing it in the key of D, basically, okay, which was his earlier versions live, anyway. So, I mean, standard tuning with a capo on the second fret, but when you've got the capo on the second fret, you have to detune, loosen off your bottom E string until it sounds like, if you were playing a C chord, the third fret on the fifth string. Okay, got that? So it's basically the rest of the five downwards are in standard tuning, but the bottom E string, the easiest way to do it is to tune up to standard, capo on the second fret, and then form a C chord and tune the bottom, loosen off the bottom E string until it sounds like the fifth string on the third fret, and then you're good to go, right? Right, so once you've got that under your belt, the next thing is this very catchy little riff he plays on the C chord, right? Okay, it's just down, up, down, up, down, up, okay? And what I'm doing there is basically you kick off, and this is where you're playing the bottom E string to get that sort of drones note for the D, okay? So what I'm doing is when I hit the first C, I'm hammering into that second fret of the fourth string from open. All right, so you go. Now what you do there is you go. Sorry. Now what you do there is you hammer up for your pinky to the third fret on the fourth string. So you go. Okay, so it, and immediately you take off the third finger, so you leave the fourth string open, and then you hammer back into that second fret. Right, so you got. the idea. So it's slowly hammer, open fourth string, hammer into that second fret on the C chord. And then you next one on that, you go, so you go down up. And then the next down, you hammer up on the fourth string to the third fret with your pinky. So you go. Look at that. And then take the pinky off, leave the fourth string open. And then hammer back into that second fret on the fourth string there. So slowly, see if you can catch this. So you come that's an upstroke with the open fourth string, and then downstroke hammering. So and then you just repeat. Okay, so. That's it, and you just speed that up just a shade and you're there. Okay, so normal speed is something like do that, just do that as many times as you like for the intro, 4 times, 6 times, however many times you want to do it. Okay, and then it goes to a G7. Now with this tuning, what I do is I rest my thumb on that bottom E string, so it mutes it. So the only chord you really want that open string on is the C. Okay, the rest of the chords in this song, you want it muted. So I rest my thumb on it. Okay. Right. So the G7 is exactly like a G7 would be, but without the third finger. Second on the fifth, first on the top E string. And I'm playing 5 downwards, right? I mean, if you've got your thumb resting on it, if you hit the bottom E string, it doesn't sound, okay? But if you leave it open, it's going to sound like a discord, okay? So you either mute it or miss it, okay? The bottom E string. The only time you need to hit that bottom E string is when you're playing the C chord, okay? And every time you're playing the C chord is this riff. G7. Now what you do there is you go G7. You must leave now, take what you need, you think. You play a 4-fingered F chord. Okay, again, mute the bottom E string with your thumb. You don't want to hear that because that's a discord again. But I'm playing a standard F, but with this third finger up to the third fret fifth string and pinky taking over on the fourth string third fret. Okay, so it's what I call 4-fingered F, or F with C in the bass. 5 downwards. Don't want to play the bottom E string, or if you do, mute it with your thumb. So, from the beginning, right, so you go G7. You must leave now, take what you need, you F, think, will, C, last. So let's just do the first line. I'll do a couple of the intros and we'll go into it, okay? So, slowly. I'll play a trumpet really slowly. There we go. Sleep now, take what you need, you think will last. Back to the G7. Whatever you wish to keep, you better F, grab it fast. C. Now play D minor. Yon, 5 downwards, D minor. Okay, 5 downwards again. You understand your F again. Orphan with his C riff. D minor. Crying like an F fire in C song. Now, nice little change here. E7. Now, it's exactly the same fingering as I normally play for an E7. That's first fret, third string, second fret on the fifth string, but you don't want the sound the bottom E again. It's five downwards, because if you hit that, you're going to get like a discord. Okay, so again, thumb over the bottom E string. So if you hit it, it doesn't sound, or miss it altogether by hitting five downwards. Okay, so it goes crying like a fire in the sun. E7. Look out, the saints are F coming. G7 through. That's line D minor, it's all over. F now, B, B, C. And that's it. Just repeats everything again for another three verses with different words. Okay? So once you've got a verse, you've got the whole song. Okay? And obviously, if you've got, you can play the harmonica, just play the same again for a harmonica solo. Okay? So let's go through it again very slowly. We'll do four, we'll do the whole thing, four intros, and then we'll play a whole verse, okay, and then just repeats, okay, for more of the same. So don't forget, the only time you want to play that open E string, bottom E string, which is tuned to the same note as the third fret on the fifth string, okay, the only time you need to play that is when you're playing the C chord. All the time you're playing the C chord, you can play that open bottom E string. All the other chords, you five down to one, or you mute it as well with your thumb. Okay, just remember that, otherwise you're going to get some horribles. Okay, so slowly, four intros, verse. Here we go. Sleep now, take what you need, you think will last. G7, body they wish to keep, you better F to C, back of this. D minor, yonder stands F, your orphan with a seeker. Riff, D minor, crying like F, the fire in the season. Riff. E7, look out, the saints F are coming. G7 through. D minor, it's all over. F now, baby blue. Four of these and then it's next verse. Here we go. The highway is for gamblers, better use your sense. Take what you have gathered from coincidence. The empty-handed painter from your streets is drawing crazy patterns on your sheets. The sky too is folding under you, and it's all over now, baby blue. And there you have it, boys and girls, another two verses exactly the same, different words, okay. And also, if you can throw in a harmonica solo, brilliant. I can't, because I don't play the harmonica. Thanks very much for watching and listening, boys and girls. I hope you enjoyed that. Don't forget, there is my new lesson list now. There's a link in the description box under the video. If you haven't already had a look at it, please do. If you want to use the search function on a mobile app, or a mobile phone, shall I say, you will need to install the app called Google Sheets, okay, otherwise the search function won't work on a mobile. Works all right on Windows, but you need the app if you're going to use a mobile device, okay, just to let you know. Thanks very much for watching and listening. See you in the next lesson. Bye for now.